We are cutting across to Dwarka in New Delhi, where wreath laying ceremony for those 10 BSF personnel who died in the air crash yesterday in Dwarka. You're looking at those latest pictures from the location. Bhavtosh is joining us. Yes, Bhavtosh, over to you.
In fact, the entire top brass of BSF, also the Home Minister and the MOS Home, Kiran Rijiju, have arrived here. Apart from them, the Defence Services officers have also come to pay respect to the 10 persons who died in that ill-fated crash that happened yesterday in Dwarka. Now, the flight was being piloted by Captain Bhagwati Prasad. In fact, he was the one who showed exemplary courage at that point of time, and instead of crash landing it in a residential area, because there were several houses in the vicinity, he took the flight to an isolated place, and the flight then met with a horrible accident in which all 10 on board died. Apart from him, there were eight other persons in that flight. They were all going to Ranchi to repair a chopper which had developed some technical snag. That chopper was used by BSF in anti-naxal operations, and it was just a short visit to Ranchi, and it was expected that they will be back in the capital by late in the evening. Mm-hmm. But that flight met with an accident. All 10 bodies have been brought to the Safdarjung Airdrome, where the head office of the BSF Air Wing is located, and when he has started, the top brass of BSF, including the DGP and other officers, will be paying their respect. The Home Minister Rajnath Singh and others have also come here.
Right. So basically right now, these are visuals coming to us from the Safdarjung Aerodrome. Bhavtosh, am I right? And tell us what exactly would be the procedure followed after this wreath laying ceremony.
Well, few of those who met with the accident they were residents of Haryana, Uttar Pradesh. The bodies will be handed over to the family members once the formal ceremony gets over. The pilot is was Delhi based. His family is present, in fact, here. Captain Bhagwati Prasad was someone who rose from the ranks in BSF. He joined BSF in 2001 and was presently a deputy commandant and also the pilot of this aircraft.
Okay.
He had over 200 hours of flying experience. In fact, most of the BSF officials and even officials from Ministry of Civil Aviation have said that as soon as he realized that the flight had developed a technical snag, and there was no point in making sure that it lands on the emergency runway, he made sure that it goes into an isolated area, and that's why the flight, in fact, met with an accident and crash-landed into an overhead water tank. Most of the BSF personnel have said that it's a huge loss for them, because the technical wing of the air wing of BSF, eight of those officers have died, and they have said it's a loss that is very hard or very tough for them to overcome.
Right. This would be a loss that would probably take years to compensate, at least in terms of the technical expertise. 10 members of the BSF technical team lost their lives. Now, Bhavtosh, when we say there's a technical snag in the plane, does that raise questions on whether these aircraft should be at all in use if this is the kind of technical snags that are happening?
Well, the particular ill-fated flight that took off yesterday from Delhi Airport, it had an engine overhaul 6 months back, so it was fit. The Airport Accident Investigation Bureau, which comes under Ministry of Civil Aviation, will look into the exact cause which led to the death, led to the tragic accident. And the investigations have just started in this case. It's too early for us to comment as to what.